Welcome to the third video in Course 2. The content for this video comes from Module 3, Publishing Long Form Scholarship. This video will discuss publishing long form scholarship and cover the characteristics of this type of scholarship. There are several types of long form scholarship. Different types have different characteristics, but all have front matter. The front matter section maps the scope and structure of the book so that the reader or user knows what to expect. Everything in the book should be reflected in the front matter in some way. Think of this section as visually outlining the work's presentation. Front matter includes the half title page and publisher's name, the copyright CC statement as well as CIP data, the full title page, and the table of contents. Front matter also includes an introduction. An introduction will describe the topic, the scope of the research and why it's important, and explain what this publication contributes to the discipline. In the case of conference, colloquia, and symposia proceedings, the introduction includes a description of the event, including program committee members, dates, and the location of the event. The front matter for monographs and edited volumes may also include a preface, acknowledgments, epigraph, foreword, as well as a list of illustrations and tables. The manuscript should be a logical progression of chapters, clearly taking the reader through the topic and making a coherent argument supported by research and study. In the case of an edited volume, it's important that the volume editors ensure that the individual contributions are consistent in approach, address the main theme of the work, and, if possible, reference other chapters that relate to their work. Particular challenges can arise when chapters are written by non-native English speakers. Editors should be especially alert for work needed to ensure both consistency and clarity. If possible, the volume editor should share the full work with every contributor, encouraging the chapter authors to reference data and elements in other chapters. This allows the reader to see more clearly the connective tissue of the volume. While it adds extra time to the overall creation, it makes for a stronger, more cohesive volume. Every monograph and most edited volumes should include a conclusion. The conclusion is more than a summary of the work presented and should provide further lines of inquiry, possible research questions that remain, and reflections on how the research has changed the author's own thinking. Do not allow the author to begin their conclusion with, "In conclusion." The back matter contains the book's supporting materials. It can include endnotes, bibliography or works cited, the appendices, an index, and may include author and editor biographies and the series lists. This is a crucial part of a monograph and edited volume, and the part that requires the most editing and coordination. The back matter maps out the author and editor's research and presents it in a way that allows others to follow the line of inquiry easily and clearly. This is what is often called the scholarship of record and is the core of a good scholarly volume. So, how can you help your authors? If your program is service-focused, your role may be to provide light guidance and support to the author who wants to make their existing manuscript openly available online. In this case, analysis of the manuscript for and creation of all the elements described above could be out of the scope of your program. Instead, you may want to ensure that the book contains an introduction and that the table of contents is correct before creating necessary metadata and uploading it to your repository. In this video, we have discussed the characteristics of long-form scholarship. Thank you for watching.